The use of ultra-high-strength steels is quite exciting. They're approximately 3 times stronger than the standard steels we build rail cars with today.
What we're trying to do is use high-strength, lightweight steel to take weight out of the car so we can pass that on to customers.
So what's exciting about the Phase 2 gondola with the ultra-high-strength steel is the increased load limit, giving Norfolk Southern's customers the chance to load more product into a rail car.
We're looking at ranges between 230 and 235,000 pounds of carrying capacity. So if you think about it, if you can get 10 to 15% more product in each car, that's fewer cars you have on site. So for every car you bring in, you can bring in that much more material.
But it also is expected to give us a more durable car that will stay in service and stay available to customers.
The quality of the steel is going to help out tremendously with normal wear and tear, and expect this car to hold up a lot better than traditional gondolas.
This has been a multi-year journey. We started approximately 3 years ago with an advanced high-strength steel gondola. We put it through a battery of tests. We squeezed the car, we impact the car, we jacked the car, and met all of those standards very easily. We put it through field service trials.
So this is kind of the natural evolution of a very innovative rail car joint venture.
This car really came together in just a little over 2 years, which is, in this industry, it's a phenomenal feat. And really, it's because of the dedication of the people that worked on the car.
The overall package is right in line with our strategy, which is based on service, productivity, and growth. So a great value driver for us, and again, a great corporation partnership with Greenbrier.
This is probably one of the bigger innovations that I've seen in quite some time.
This is what NS and Greenbrier are both about. They're about innovation and they're about partnerships. And what we saw here today with the car is exactly a good example.